Good morning, children. Children, we have gone through the chapter Meena Makes a Friend. Now, after this chapter, I will clear the exercise and we will just do it now. Okay? So, I will read the question here. This is your exercise. Okay? I will write even page number also so that it is clear to you. Page number 17. It starts from page number 17. Okay, 17 to 19. Okay, now let's see. 19, 20 also we have. Yeah, we'll do till 20. So I will start reading the question and answers I will show from the board. First one is circle the correct answer. There are two options given for each question and we need to circle the correct one. Meena is a tortoise or a squirrel? Children, recall the chapter. Meena was a tortoise or a squirrel? She was a squirrel. So we will circle squirrel. I am writing, I have written your answer. You will circle it. Okay? You can do along with me. You can take your textbooks and do this exercise along with me. Okay, so that you don't make any mistake. Number 2. Meena's class teacher is Pinky or Mr. Hari. Two names are given. Pinky or Mr. Hari. So, Meena's class teacher is Mr. Hari and he is a hare. Okay. Meena's new friend is Toto or Raju. Meena's new friend was Raju. Raju made friendship with Meena and he is a fox and Toto was a tortoise. Number 4. Meena and Raju play game of catch. They played game of catch. Here two options are given. It is catch or football. But they played catch. Next, we come to question number 2. That is A2. First question I give you. How many other animals are sitting at the round table? There were 3 other animals sitting at the round table when Mr. Hari introduces Meena to the class. Clear, children? Hope you are with me. I am not going very fast. I have written the answer. So, you can see the answer and write. Okay. Number 2. Which animal is wearing a red scarf? Which animal was wearing? Fox was wearing a red scarf. Here, question is asked which animal. We need to write animal. So, we are not writing name of animal. We are writing only an animal. So, fox was wearing the red scarf. Which animal became Meena's friend? Again, fox became Meena's friend. What is the name of Fluffy Bunny? Name of Fluffy Bunny was Pinky. Who introduces Meena to the class? Class teacher is Mr. Hari. Mr. Hari introduces Meena to the class. Now, here for A3, question number A3, we are given 3 pictures. 3 pictures of a cap, scarf and a bow. See here, 3 pictures are given of a cap, scarf and bow. Now, we need to, things are given below which animals were wearing. Okay, color them the same colors in the story given. Now, these cap, scarf and bow, these animals were wearing. See the chapter and color it again, which color they were wearing it. Okay. So, here you will do this coloring activity on your own. Now, let's shift to exercise B1. That is, match the following. We will do this match the following first. Okay. Now, children, we are ready with match the following. Now, first we are given here shapes and the objects to that shape is given to the opposite side. Okay, now what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to just write the numbers here. We are not going to match with the lines. As I told, we are not going to just match with the lines because your book looks untidy. Okay. where you don't have any option you can do, but here already numbers are given to you, so you can write numbers at the back side of this object. Okay, so we'll start with the first one. Now first one is what? First one is circle. Number one is circle. Now we can find circle, objects of a circle. How these objects are given? Here one tire is given and one round balloon is given to you. See, I am making proper round. So this is circle. We will put here number. As I told you, this number only we are going to put in the answer block. We will put this number only. Okay, when you also do at home, you practice, match the following doing in this way. Okay, so number one is circle. We found out object and we are writing that number one in front of that object. Okay, number two is square. Now we have to find out where is square. Okay, here a chessboard is given and a Ludo dice is given. So this is a square. So we will write which number is given square. Number two. I will write number two here. Are you getting me, children? Are you clear? Yeah. Come on, we move forward. Triangle. Triangle shape is here. Okay. Pizza. You eat pizza. And one triangle shape is given. A Xmas tree or Christmas tree, what you say? So number is three. So these three only will put here. This is number three answer. Same rectangle. Rectangle, we have got the last option left out. A bundle of, I think bundle of money. Yeah. And bundle of notes we have and a matchbox. So here we'll write number four. So we have got all the numbers. Number one, two, three, and four. This way we completed our match the following. Children, you also do match the following in this way so that your book will not spoil. Clear? Next, we shift to next page, page number here, page B2. We'll do this. B2 is written here on the top and page number is 19. Okay. So here you can see I have made a rainbow, drawing of a rainbow. Clouds are made here. Now in this you are given some fill in the blanks also, and you are supposed to write the colors of rainbow. Okay, now this we will do here. I'll show you how to fill colors in the stripes in the arc of rainbow. So now children, I have drawn a rainbow for you with all seven, identifying all seven colors. Now we will proceed and how you are supposed to fill the color also I will show you. Now the best way to remember the colors of the rainbow is to learn a spelling. Learn a spelling, that is Vidgyor. Now with this Vidgyor letter, for each letter you will know the colors of rainbow arc. How? You need to remember these letters in each arc. It starts like this. V-I-B-G-Y-O-R. That is called Vidgyor. Okay, seven colors of rainbow. Now, V stands for violet. I stands for indigo. B stands for blue. G stands for green. Yellow. Y for yellow. O for orange. And last, R for red. So, if you remember these letters, that is the word Vidgyor, then you are able to color this rainbow properly. All seven colors will come in this arc. Okay. Here you can color any color like grey color or black clouds, because it is rainy season. You are showing in rainy season only rainbows are formed. How rainbows are formed? With the droplets of water and sun mixing together forms rainbow. Okay. So that time whatever color you feel like your rainbow looks, you can color this with these colors and your clouds your own choice. Okay, I'll show you one sample I have done for you. See here, I have made how beautiful it looks after filling the color. I wish your rainbow will also look so beautiful if you follow these steps. Okay, clear? Now come on, let us write the spellings given in your exercise. So this word is spelled with your. Okay. Now we will start writing the words. Now here already now in your box it is given some colors and mentioned. Seeing these colors only you are going to write the colors in front of that dash, in front of that box you are going to write. Number one is given violet.
V I O L E T.
Number two is indigo. Number three is blue. Number four is given green. Number five you will see yellow. Number six is orange. And number seven is red. Same as I have written here, V for violet, I for indigo, blue for V for blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange, and R for red. So this way you will complete your rainbow and see how beautiful it looks after coloring it. So this is your activity and this is your most favorite activity, I feel. You will enjoy this doing. So children, we have completed this coloring activity here. Now we shift to next page, that is use of he, she, it. That means we have done pronouns. We will write now answers of this exercise. Okay, now here we will start with C2. Now in C2 what is written? The squirrel made a loud noise. Now dash was hungry. Here we are supposed to use he, she or it. That means wherever required we will use he, she or it. Now you recall what we have learned in pronouns. We have learned he is used for a boy or male, she is used for female, and it is used for any object or anything or a name of animals, right? Now in this sentence, a squirrel is a name of animal. So we will write it was hungry. The squirrel made a loud noise. It was hungry. Next, my mother does not like to be late. So here mother is girl, boy, who she? She, mother is she. So she is a girl or woman. We are talking about she. So mother is she. She is always on time. John liked popcorn very much. Dash finished the whole bag. Now who is John? John is a boy. So for boy we will write he. Okay? Come on, let us complete two more numbers. Okay, next. Number four. Rama is my neighbor. Dash lives next door. Now Rama is name of a boy. So what I will write? He. He lives next door. Next. I like to ride my bicycle. Dash goes very fast. Now in this sentence, I am talking about my bicycle. That means I am referring to bicycle. Now a bicycle is a animal, thing, place, people, what? Bicycle is a name of a thing. So we will write here it.